Some astronomers believe that there may be so-called exotic stars in the universe that aren't made up of the usual electrons, protons, and neutrons that make up our sun and all of its relatives. Despite the fact that these unusual stars are still just theories, researchers are beginning to uncover evidence that suggests some of them may possibly exist. Here is a list of the strangest and most exotic stars that may exist in outer space. Supermassive neutron stars are thought to be the ancestors of blitzars. The star is protected from gravitational collapse into a black hole by centrifugal forces produced by the extremely fast spinning of the star. A neutron star spins so quickly that the star's stuff is kept from slipping below the event horizon by the centrifugal force of the star. A neutron star's rapid rotation makes it a typical pulsar, but after a few million years, the pulsar's potent magnetic field, which emits energy and decreases angular momentum, slows the rotation to the point where centrifugal forces are no longer sufficient to prevent the pulsar from undergoing black hole formation. In the process of the blitzer formation, a portion of the pulsar's magnetic field that is external to the black hole abruptly separates from its disappearing source. This magnetic energy rapidly transforms into a radio flash with a broad energy range. The above-mentioned collapses can account for the observation of 7 such transient radio emitters as of January 2015. Before the first typical stars were created, dark matter stars would have already been present. And if they really exist, they might even be around right now. These hypothetical stars would primarily be composed of ordinary matter, in contrast to what you may assume based on their names. Specifically, hydrogen and helium, just like our sun. These dark stars would, however, also contain a sizable quantity of neutralino dark matter. Neutralinos are a form of fictitious particle that some physicists believe may make up dark matter, similar to how atoms make up ordinary matter. According to theories, neutralino particles act as their own form of antimatter. That implies that they will fully demolish one another if they come into contact, producing enormous amounts of heat and energy. Dark matter stars would be able to burn brightly for billions of years without ever needing to collapse in order to ignite nuclear fusion, which is a need for conventional stars, thanks to the raw power of neutralino annihilation. Dark stars may therefore develop into enormous, puffy giants that reach diameters of tens or even thousands of astronomical units. However, despite their size, these stars would be extremely dim and possibly imperceptible to the human eye, due to the lack of fusion and the low temperatures. Particle collider tests haven't yet been able to produce any solid proof of neutralinos. And these ghostly stars won't exist until that takes place, or until a dark matter star suddenly appears in the space. A hypothetical celestial object known as a boson star is made of boson-like particles. Conventional stars are formed from mostly protons, which are fermions, but also consist of helium-4 nuclei, which comprise bosons. A stable type of boson with self-repulsive interaction is necessary for this kind of star to exist. One potential candidate particle is the still hypothetical axion, which is also a candidate for the not yet detected non-baryonic dark matter particles, which appear to make up about 25% of the mass of the universe. Boson stars are predicted to be transparent and undetectable, as opposed to regular stars, which emit radiation as a result of gravitational pressure and nuclear fusion. An area of darkness mimicking the event horizon of a black hole would be formed by the powerful gravitational field of a compact boson star, which would also bend light around the object. A boson star, like a black hole, would suck conventional matter from its surroundings, but because to its transparency, its center would still be observable because of matter, which would likely heat up and radiate. According to simulations, boson matter would take on a torus or donut shape due to centrifugal forces, which would cause rotating boson stars to be torus-shaped. According to some analyses, scientists may have previously seen two boson stars collide. A strangely enormous black hole collided with another one in May 2019, and the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory captured the resulting waves in spacetime. The two stars had masses that were around 66 and 85 times that of the Sun, respectively, exceeding the limits that current theories predict should be feasible due to the death of massive stars. It's likely that each of these black holes is the result of the merger of several smaller black holes in the past. However, the scientists discovered that such an outcome would be identical to the collision of two dark boson stars after running that possibility through their models. A Torne-Zytkow object is created when a neutron star collides with another star, usually a red giant or supergiant. Simply drifting stars may be the objects colliding. Only in exceptionally dense globular clusters is this likely to happen. Alternately, if one of the two stars in a binary system undergoes a supernova, a neutron star may develop in that system. Since no supernova is fully symmetrical and the binding energy of the binary fluctuates as mass is lost in the supernova, the neutron star will still have some velocity in relation to its initial orbit. This kick may result in its companion's new orbit crossing over with it, or if the companion is a main sequence star, it may be devoured when the companion turns red giant. These hybrid stars were first imagined in 1977 by physicists Kip Thorne and Anna Zytkow, thus their name. However, Torne-Zytkow objects gained significant attention again in 2014 after scientists claimed to have discovered one in the star HV2112. But that revelation has continued to stir up debate throughout the years. Quark stars are objects with densities that fall between those of a neutron star and a black hole. Quarks are an elementary particle that combine to generate the protons and neutrons in atomic nuclei, acting as a building block for matter. Quark stars would therefore be created almost exclusively of quarks, similar to how neutron stars are made almost entirely of neutrons. Researchers have hypothesized that these unusual stars could be the remains of massive neutron stars whose particles have been simmering for ages. NASA revealed almost two decades ago that observations performed with the Hubble and Chandra Space Observatories may have seen a candidate for a quark star known as 3C58. This hasn't been proven or disproved as of yet. The star's peculiar behavior, such as abrupt temperature changes, is inconsistent with what is thought to be typical of neutron stars by astronomers. A new quark star candidate has recently been discovered. We previously discussed this in one of our videos. The reference is available beneath this video. An electroweak star is a hypothetical variety of exotic star in which radiation pressure from electroweak burning, or the energy produced by the conversion of quarks to leptons via the electroweak force, prevents the star's gravitational collapse. This process takes place in a space near the star's core that is roughly the size of an apple containing two Earth masses and reaches temperatures around 1015 K. The life cycle of a star that results in the formation of an electroweak star is thought to start after a supernova collapse. When gravitational pull can no longer be withstood by quark degeneracy pressure but may still be withstood by electroweak burning radiation pressure, electroweak stars, which are denser than quark stars, may develop. A star's life cycle during this stage could span up to 10 million years. An electroweak star's ability to produce energy is constrained by the rate at which quarks are produced. An iron star is a speculative type of compact star that might exist in the cosmos in the very distant future, possibly after 10 to the 1,500 years. Cold fusion via quantum tunneling would lead the light nuclei in common matter to fuse into iron 56 nuclei, according to the theory underlying the genesis of iron stars. Then, stellar mass objects would become cold spheres of iron as a result of fission and alpha particle emission turning heavy nuclei into iron. Only under conditions where the universe may last for a very long time and where the proton is stable are such stars capable of forming. Nearly all of these things are still just ideas. But then again, depictions of real wacky cosmic phenomena that were formerly thought to be science fiction are now abundant in astronomy textbooks. Who can predict what other odd artifacts we will find in the years to come?